Hey, what's up guys, welcome to Fine Gap, and in today's video I'm going to explain how to use React useState hook in your ReactJS project. So without any delay, let's start. So first of all, you can see that I have created a new ReactJS project and this is its output. So what I am going to do, I will open the app.js component, which is our main component, remove this header section. You can see that currently this is our blank empty page. Next, what I'm going to do, I will type here a h1 tag, use state tutorial by FineGap. You can see the title here. Next, I will create an input element here like this. So you can see that we have an input element. Let me zoom in a little bit. And in the last, I will create a p element where we will display the text but using useState hook. Okay, so this was our HTML. Next, what we have to do, we have to type here our useState function, useState. You must have to import useState from React first before using this in your React component. Then this is a function, and inside this I will pass the initial value. For example, if I type here FineGap, so you can see that. And next, we have to write here something like this, constant, and here we will define two variables. The first variable would be maybe company name. So this can be any name. It's depend upon you that which name you want to give at here. It is same as defining a variable. And the second is set company name. Again, this is this variable will receive a callback function from this useState. And if you don't understand this, basically this is a destructive assignment in JavaScript. This is a technique in which we can assign arrays elements to multiple variables at once. If you did not know this concept, you can learn on the internet about destructive assignment. So basically this is a callback function now, and this will be our state. Okay, so what we are going to do, I'm going to type here on change. We have to call a function here like set my state. And we will call this function, and now we have to define this function here same as we define a function in JavaScript, like function set my state. And we know that we receive default parameter, which is event. And here I will define a variable, let user input is equal to event.target.value. And now let me type here alert user input. Okay, first of all, I want to check that either this function is working or not. Okay, here is an error. So we don't have to type these parameters here. React will by default understand that this is a function and I have to call this. Here you can see that this is our output. Let me type here F. So you can see that F value is printed on our alert. Next, I will simply this callback function name and paste here. And inside this, I will pass the user input's value that user will type from this input inside my this set company state function that I have declared at this position. And in the last, what I'm going to do, we will directly print that state, which is currently company name at this position. And now let me refresh. So you can see that on first refresh, the value is FineGap because the initial value we passed was FineGap. But later, once I will start typing like tutorial, so you can see that the state is changing. And in React, as you know, that when your state is changed, your React read under your component. So friends, this was the technique that how we can use a useState hook in your ReactJS project. I hope that this video will be helpful for you. If you have any question, you can ask us in the comment section. We will try to answer your question. And please subscribe to our YouTube channel for our regular videos. And finally, thanks for watching.